Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive. Today, we're taking a look at the SC-13 Special from our friends at Martin. Now, if you're not familiar with the SC-13 line of guitars, these are potentially the most playable Martin guitars that have ever been made. This thing absolutely rips. It sounds killer plugged in as well. Interestingly enough, in that intro, even though we had a microphone positioned right here, you were in fact listening to the DI, which should tell you how good this guitar sounds plugged in. To that end, we're going to take a quick listen to it through the microphone, and then we'll talk a little bit more deeply about the specifications and what makes this particular version of this guitar tick. So now I've had a chance to listen to the plugged in and unplugged sound of this guitar, let's talk more about the spec. We're going to begin as we always do at the headstock. So starting at the headstock, it appears that all is quiet on the Western front with Martin's traditional headstock design. However, if we flip it over and show you the tuners, you'll get a good look, first of all, at how beautiful these tuners are with this kind of cutout design going on there. But also, we can see the open gears on the back. Now, what's interesting about this in particular is that you'll notice that these gears are different for each individual string. Now, this seems like an obvious thing, but believe me, this is not something that we see on that many guitars. Normally you get an open gear design, they're all about the same, but these are individually geared per string, which is gonna improve tuning accuracy. It's also gonna make them nice and easy to use. You're not gonna find that thing where you have to tune one string like miles and miles and miles to get it to pitch, and then the other one is far too coarse in terms of its adjustment. That's just a nice touch from our friends at Martin. Now, I like the open gear design as well. We can also get a look at the back of the hardwood neck. Don't pay too much attention to that heel. We'll come into that. This hardwood neck on there, this is so slim and playable. It is not even funny. This feels like a very, very comfortable electric neck. It's an asymmetrical profile, and it's been designed to be supremely quick and playable. We also have an ebony fretboard. We have 20 frets and a 13th fret neck joint, which is unusual, but again, that's where the SC-13 comes from. Now, the reason for that 13th fret neck joint rather than the 12 and 14 that we typically see on a cutaway acoustic guitars is this. This is the dovetail neck joint, but you'll notice it's been done with a screw. Now, this is done on purpose. This is not some kind of cost-cutting measure, because this is not a cheap guitar by any stretch. This has been done so that we can adjust the guitar's action height using this fella right here. That's going to give us the option to adjust the playability of this guitar so we can get it sitting just how we like, crucially, without having to change the height of the saddle. Now, that in turn, if you change the height of the saddle, you start to sand things down, it can affect the performance of the piezo pickup system, but it can also affect the unplugged tone of the guitar because you can have a different amount of downward pressure on the bridge. So that's a really nice touch from Martin. Again, they've done this for playability reasons more than anything else. So that is very, very cool. We can also get a look at the back and sides, which are made of ziricote, which is a really pretty and, you know, very, very nice sounding wood. It's also something that I struggle to say in my accent, ziricote. You get these words every once in a while that just aren't compatible with Northeastern, but even still, we'll flip it back over. We'll get a look at the front. It's a spruce top, solid spruce, as you would expect from a Martin guitar at this price point. Again, this is not the most expensive Martin you're going to find, but it's certainly not cheap by any stretch of the imagination. This is a premium instrument. So we have a solid spruce top with this lovely sunburst finish. Natural is also available. The usual deal with the piezo pickup under here, we have, this is probably my only criticism of this guitar. I'm having so much fun playing this instrument, but my only criticism is down here in the sound hole, we have the usual gently tucked away volume and tone. These are just a little bit too far this way for my liking, because when you adjust the tone, you have to get your finger on the low E string, which mutes it, which means it's difficult to adjust it mid-performance. That is probably an oversight more than anything else. And let's be honest, that is the nitpickiest of nitpicks from my perspective. But you know, I gotta bring these things up. But even still, that is a tiny, tiny nitpick. And of course, as you've heard, the plugged-in performance is wonderful. So let me show you how it plugs in real quick. We've got a battery door down here. There's our strap pin, there's our battery door, and there's our jack socket. That's where you plug this guitar in. And when you plug it in, as you've heard already, it sounds absolutely fantastic, but most importantly, it's very, very good at rejecting feedback. So you can actually use this with a bit of distortion if you'd like, we'll explore in a minute, some compression, some effects. So if you're a plugged in acoustic player, if you use an amplifier, for example, this guitar is gonna be your best friend. It sounds really, really killer. And of course, the fact that it plays so swiftly, that really marries up with the plugged in performance too. And also we have this huge cutaway and these 20 frets up here. We can actually use these frets. Now these are occasionally purely decorative on some guitars. That is not the case here. These frets all sound fantastic. They play very well thanks to a very low action and a really great factory setup. This is not your typical kind of like Martin D18, for example, with quite a robust setup. Let's say this is a very much a player setup, and believe me, I'm happy to see it. You can get up here and you can play leads up this end all day long. You can play high chord voicings. They intonate really well. Let's actually take a second and explore that. So we're gonna go back to the plugged in sound for this, and we'll explore how it sounds when we start playing some single note lines, maybe some quite fast single note lines, starting up here in the dusty end. Now, while this guitar does sound absolutely fantastic unplugged, as you heard in our previous example, for me, it really shines plugged in. This is very much a gigging musician's guitar, in my opinion, and a real high-performance gigging musician's guitar at that. So to that end, let's explore how this guitar deals with some signal processing. Now, to keep this fair, we're gonna have the monitors in our studio turned up fairly loud to see how well this guitar handles some feedback rejection. We're gonna begin with an ambient sound with a bit of compression applied, some reverb and some delay, and we'll maybe even do a shimmer reverb because that tends to kind of set things off, especially if we're bringing a low octave, it can kind of bring about some feedback issues. Then we'll throw a tube screamer on top for a bit of distortion, because tube screamers, believe it or not, do get on very, very well with acoustic guitars if your guitar can handle it in terms of feedback rejection. So let's take a listen to that and we'll see how well this guitar performs with some heavy signal processing. So there you go, guys, that's been a look at the Martin SC-13 Special. This is absolutely, to my mind, the most playable Martin that certainly I've ever played, I think has ever existed. And most importantly, it still sounds like a Martin. So if you're looking for that classic sonic signature, but perhaps need something a little bit more high performance, maybe you like to play a lot of notes, you like to get up and play some high chord voicings, and you find the, let's call them muscular setups, of traditional Martins a little bit off-putting, this is absolutely a guitar for you to look at. And of course, that plugged-in performance is second to none. Once again, this is the SC-13 Special from our friends at Martin. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.